There's nothing so cute as when a man with absolutely no integrity starts assailing the integrity of others. Obama's CIA director, John Brennan, saying Vladimir Putin may have something on President Trump. Brennan today speculating freely that President Trump congratulated the Russian president on his re-election because, as he put it, Putin might have something on him. Well, we know for sure the House Intelligence Committee has something on Brennan, and that something is a possible perjury charge. Brennan lied about the phony Trump dossier, saying it had nothing to do with the Obama administration's investigation into Russian meddling, that he had no idea the Clinton campaign paid for the phony dossier. Both statements, outright lies. Joining me now, and did I mention John Brennan also lied about spying on the Senate Intelligence Committee? He spied on them, and then he lied about it. Not the guy you really want being the referee on integrity. Chris Farrell, Director of Investigations, Research for Judicial Watch, joining us. It is great to see you. My head starts hurting when I listen to John Brennan do anything. But there was a terrific picture of Clapper and Comey and Brennan, and they look like the three most morose hangdog and I would think characterless people in public life today. I mean, they look the parts they've played for 10 years.
It's the troika of commissars.
Well, commissars, a trio of spies, and I don't know what all they are. But I do know this. Mueller is the special counsel, and I have had a bellyful. I mean, I really had it. He's tainted. I talked with Alan Dershowitz here last night.
Right.
Alan Dershowitz is saying he should never have been the special counsel. Alan Dershowitz is saying it's time. It's time to acknowledge that fact and move ahead. But it really resides with Mueller, doesn't it, whether he goes or he stays?
Well, the president has the final word.
Well, I know he has the authority. Practically, I don't know if that's the case.
Well, it's a political question for the president whether he decides he's just had enough. And obviously, he'll take heat. There'll be all sorts of screaming and wailing. But he gets to call the shots. He's the chief executive, and he's the president. So it's with him. However, you know, the situation with Mueller is every single thing that's come up or derived from all this Russian nonsense is tainted. It is fruit of the poisonous tree, which is an old legal term going back 80 years, but still valid today, wherein any evidence obtained unlawfully or through any sort of illegal act on the behalf of law enforcement or prosecutors can't be used, and anything derived from that can't be used as evidence. This is criminal law matter.
So is there anything that Mueller has done that wouldn't be contaminated, tainted, as you put it?
No, because what you have is Mueller even acknowledging that he had a huge problem with Strzok being on his staff, because Strzok, he's got his fingers in everything. He was in the Hillary Clinton email server case. He's in this phony Russia case with the Steele dossier. So the fact that Mueller realized that Strzok was a problem and canned him is an admission that he knows anything that comes out of that, actually all those investigations, is this fruit of the poisonous tree. It's this idea that you can't take bad evidence and pretend that you got it some other way. And anything that derives from that is equally inadmissible. And well, so he's got garbage.
Putting garbage that he has collected is also known to Rod Rosenstein, the Deputy Attorney General, the Attorney General Jeff Sessions. Why don't they take steps to end it now and cut their losses? Because they know that it cannot, in any sense of equity, proceed from here because it will lead to nothing.
And Mueller knows that ethical obligation that he has. He's demonstrated it both with the FISA warrant nonsense and Strzok. And so since he knows that he's under the gun here, I think that he's reluctant to admit that the whole thing's a sham and nothing can really be used because it's been obtained unlawfully. And so he's trying to go about some way to either rehabilitate the evidence or to find some other lesser charges to use. Because, look, prosecutors are built for two things. Indictments and convictions.
I keep hearing this. I got to say to you, I don't know what the hell they're built for, but I do know that there is an American tradition of fairness and an impartial judiciary and legal process.
Not with Mueller, there isn't.
Well, he's made that very clear. As the president says, he put together a team of hardened Democrats and Hillary Clinton donors and said devil take the hindmost. But the fact is that responsible, too, are Rosenstein and Sessions, McConnell and Ryan. They're non-entities when it comes to their integrity and support of this president. So I don't know what part they play. But Rosenstein and Sessions should certainly, do you not think, get rid of Mueller and end this nonsense now? Because talk about evidence, rehabilitating it, there is no evidence.
You are correct. And they're standing around with their hands in their pockets when they should really move to shut the thing down. If Mueller had any integrity, any conscience, based on his ethical obligation, he would shut it down, resign, terminate the whole thing, because it is collapsing on itself in slow motion. The problem is it's too slow.
It's too slow, it's slow-witted, slow walking. I don't know how much. It's as if the United States Justice Department has no energy. It has no integrity at the top. They think that it's entirely appropriate to take a year of the public's life, the government's life, this nation's life, and just squander it and subvert this president. And they ought. There's a special place reserved in hell, surely, for such people. Chris Farrell, thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Lou.